H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
So why you are learning it? So JSPs are Java Server Pages, basically a technology which is a backbone of entire UI plus backend kind of technology. So this was the first technology came, okay? We cannot say first though, but yes, what I can say, first revolutionary technology came where objects has been used within HTML content, okay? Real Java objects are used, or programming language objects are used in UI contexts, and JSP was the first to try such kind of scenarios. Okay, but with that, that's the backbone of thing. But do you really need that today? No. Is somebody gonna ask you questions on this? No. Okay, is this the latest technology? Definitely not. This is the oldest technology rather. But why we learn it? Just like I told you, like servlet is the backbone of everything. Even if you are learning any kind of framework, which is even Spring Boot or Spring or MVC or Struts or anything, ultimately it's gonna have Servlet behind the scene. Okay, that's not true for JSP. JSP is gone and it's gone. Okay, so it's not like that. So we have many other technologies like HTML, jQuery, Ajax, AngularJS, Node.js, React.js, which are powerful enough to interact with the database itself. Okay, so when what is used in place of that's what I told you, all the technologies, right? So all these technologies are being used to today's market to interact with the database. Okay, let's give me one sec. Right, that's fine. So now we will be learning React.js, we will be learning Angular. Okay, we are not learning React. I'm trying to actually change that content from website says React, but it's actually Angular, because people are facing, there are a lot of jobs available in that area, not in React. If you want, I can take it, not a big deal. Okay, or there are videos available with me. Okay, cool with that. Cool. So what is Java Server Pages? Java Server Pages is a technology of developing web pages that supports dynamic content, which helps developer to insert Java code in HTML pages. Now you are doing reverse. Up to this one, what you are doing? You are writing HTML. Okay, where did that go? Any servlet, just open that any servlet here, and what you did, you actually wrote HTML tags in Java. Now I want to reverse that scenario. I want HTML tags holding Java. I don't want Java holding HTML, correct? So up to this point, we were sending like this. So we are writing HTML inside Java. I want to reverse the scenario. I want to write what? I want to write an HTML page with Java in it, and when you combine them together, it's called as Java Server Pages. Would be that, so it's called as JSP. Simple as that. Now, HTML pages by making the special JSP tags, and most of it starts with this. So this is called JSP tag. Okay, so it's not like HTML tag. It will. So remember, HTML tags looks like this. Remember this. You create login.html. I want it on editor. So normal tags are basically a simple XML tags. Now you want to change that to an HTML. So this is normal tag, right? Okay, and JSP tags like this. Okay, it has additional percentage to it. What with that? Using JSP, you can collect input from users to the web page forms, present a record from the database to another source, and create a web pages dynamically. Would be that. So why to use JSP? So there are some technologies like JSP called as so any replacement of this, Active Server Pages, Pure Servlet, Server Side Includes, this is gone. Okay, please understand this one. This is interesting. This is a best thing. What is JSP and how JSP really works? When I say that, I'm actually going to embed HTML into sorry, embed Java into HTML, what exactly is going on? Remember that web server do not understand HTML. Web server understands Java, okay, because your application server understands Java. You do not have HTML processor, you have Java processor, correct? HTML processor is your browser. So your browser understands HTML and your web server understands Java, and you need some kind of conversion in between. And JSP solves the purpose in between. Now, what we have to worry about web server as of now? So there is something called JSP Servlet Engine. Basically, this is an app server. Okay, we used to call it an app server or application server. And JSP files are stored here, but there is a conversion process. The conversion process is like this. So when you ask for JSP, let's say get slash hello.jsp. When you ask for this, what happens is server goes to the engine, okay, wherever you actually stored this hello.jsp, it reads it. And what server do is from this JSP, it converts that to a hello servlet.java. Who converts that? Server converts that. Do you care? No. Do you want to see this Java file? No. Do you execute and compile this? No. Who does that? Server. So what you write is hello.jsp, it reads it. Who? Server converts it into hello servlet.java. Now what happened? It's a Java file. Server understands Java. It will compile the Java file and create hello servlet.class. Got it? So now onwards, not even now onwards, whenever there is a request for hello.jsp, it will actually execute this hello servlet.class and return the response. Now it will be a normal flow happening just like in servlet. Correct? So we have servlet like structure ready, and you will be able to handle request and response in the servlet itself. Got it? So there is an additional process of conversion, additional process of adding this stuff, which is like reading the JSP page and converting that into a servlet. So ultimately, even if I am saying Java server pages, okay, this is only for you. For server, JSP is getting converted to what? Servlet. Remember this. Got it? Any questions up to this point? So ultimately, we are running servlets. So all the methods, all the things which are possible in servlets are possible in JSP. Correct? That means you can do request dispatcher, session, request, context, all kind of attributes, everything, because it's ultimately what? A servlet. So JSP is a servlet. Only thing is you reversed the way of writing it. That's it. And it's reversed for you, not for server. Server gonna take it as a servlet only. Got it? Any questions up to this point? Okay. Let's write the first JSP. Before even doing anything like this, let's write the first JSP and complete this. So I'm going to close everything, and instead of login.html, you're going to create something called index.jsp, a very simple one. And JSPs are written in web content directly. So you can just see below just HTML file, this is called JSP file. If you don't find it, just go to other and then type it in. Not an issue. So you just say JSP. You can see JSP file and tag. You have to use JSP file. Next. Okay, write it in web content. You can create one more folder inside this, but you don't need that as of today. Say index.jsp. Click on next. HTML file. Okay, HTML file. And done. Now we will understand details of this. Okay, so what is this thing and everything. But you can see that ultimately it's an HTML page having head into it and title into it and everything. Would be that it's not aligned properly. Let's do that. And this is like welcome page. Okay. And then you can have a p tag here. Okay. With h1, you're gonna just publish that this is my first JSP. And now we're going to add the content here. Okay. And we'll actually explore the content from JSP as well. And ptag completes. And it's start ptag. what happened. Anyway, that's fine. So now what I really care whether how it actually runs. So this will get converted into Java and it will get executed. So what is a life cycle of entire JSP? Let's understand that. So life cycle starts with compilation, initialization and execute. And there is a process which is called as parsing. So this is how it works. Initialization, which is JSP init function. It is very similar to init function of a servlet. Then you have JSP service method, which is actually taking request and response methods, which is having a main logic, which is very similar to do service methods like do post, do get and all those things. And you have shutdown method, which is JSP destroy. And there is an additional step called JSP compilation, where parsing of JSP happens. Parsing meaning you are having a completing tags, okay, and syntax and all those things will be checked. Turning the JSP into a servlet. This is something done by who? Server. Compiling the servlet, again server. So all these three actions are completed by who? Server again. Then you have JSP init function, which is initialization, execution and cleanup. Do you care about these methods? Absolutely not. You just need to know that this is a life cycle, but this is not something which is accessible to you. This is something happens within and you don't actually care. Okay, but you do have access to objects. Got it? So this is like answering a question in interview, but it doesn't make any sense to you because what you're going to do is this, right? So let's run this thing and see whether you are able to access your index.jsp and you're running that index.jsp for you. Good with this? And then you will learn awesome things about JSP. Meanwhile, Servo starts, we'll go through the materials. Now the first thing and very important thing is called a scriptlet. Scriptlet can contain any number of Java language statements. Now remember that why we created JSP? To write Java into it. To write Java into HTML. Where do you write that? You write that in scriptlets. Scriptlets are Java accessor methods. Okay, so we're gonna write our first scriptlet and after that we'll take some important objects in JSP. Let's run the, so, okay, this is running. So now, okay, see this. This is my first JSP. Now, surprisingly, why and how? Because I did not actually call index.jsp. Okay, I did not actually call. I never gave the path here. How come this is executed? Anybody knows the answer? Without even asking for index.jsp, why it came here? JSP is only for front-end validation. No, JSP for front-end itself. Okay, you can write front-end itself. Java server pages. Okay, why actually this thing came? Because you defined it in web.xml. In web.xml, there is an entry for it, which is called as welcome page. So if you define a welcome page, remember we had a welcome page list, and in that welcome page, there were a lot of things, and I just only kept index.jsp. I did that intentionally on day number one because I wanted to write an index.jsp today. So now this is index.jsp. This is a welcome page. Whenever you are hitting a web server without any page, this page will land on it. Okay, so this is your starting page, home page of an application. Good with that. So this is my first JSP and we printed that on page. Now starting from that, this point, we're gonna write a JSP content into our index.jsp. Are you clear? So now what you have to do, you have to write your scriptlet. So go ahead and write your first ever scriptlet. So scriptlets are written like this. This is a scriptlet tag. Okay. Now, before writing scriptlet, you need to understand what is the difference between a normal comment and JSP comment. So in HTML, the comments are declared like this. If you are done with the course of HTML on YouTube, you know this thing. This is HTML comment. Okay. And if you just append this to an HTML comment, this is called JSP comment. Okay. Good with this. This is JSP comment. This is called scriptlets. Scriptlets are used to write Java code into it. So if I write system.out.println, it's completely fine here. Okay. So let's continue. So now we are going to create hello H2K students and your IP address is request.getRemoteAddress. This is what I'm gonna find. So first thing is hello H2K student. This is, I can write it here. Okay, and here I'm gonna say out dot. See, I got the methods. I got println. Okay, and then here you are mentioning your IP address is you say request dot. I say request and my Siri started. I don't know why. Get remote address. Cool. This is a Java statement. I didn't write anything related to HTML. What I did is pure Java statement. It says out.println. Your IP address is request.getRemoteAddress. So this is request object. This is out object. Out.println. This is not HTML. This is Java. Correct? And you can write that in scriptlet tag. So scriptlets are what? So scriptlet can contain any number of Java language statements, variable or method declarations or expressions that are valid in the page scripting language. Okay, page scripting language, page language Java. Okay, we'll come back to that. So now we did this, let's run this. We do not want to actually, so servers generally, if it is synchronized, it's gonna take the latest changes. If it doesn't, only then we'll restart. So just refresh this, and you got hello H2K students, and your IP address is this one. You got this. There are two more things we're gonna learn, and we'll try to understand how in the world it got to know that this is out, this is request. Where exactly we declared those variables, that we're gonna learn. But before that, I have to tell you two important things. One is called as declarations, and another is called as expressions. We'll learn, we'll take the example, and we'll learn about these objects. Okay, the second part is declarations. If you want to declare variables, and generally we do that. So if you are creating a bean, okay, or customer class, what you do, customer private name, first name, last name, zip code, address, all those variables you define first. And then have accessor methods or logic into it, right? So we have a tendency to declare some variable first. You can do that in JSP as well. Although scriptlets allow declaration of variables as well, you can handle declarations separately with declaration tag. Declaration tags is just a scriptlet with exclamation into it. That's it. So you can add a declaration like this. This is a declaration. Okay, and you can use that variable wherever you want. Okay, so you can use that variable here. So out dot, again you have println or print, and then you can define like value declared for I, and you define some value 100 or 10 or whatever is, and there will be plus I. And it will not give any error to you. I is known to this because you defined it. Okay, J will be an error because J is not defined. J is unknown. Okay, I is known because you declared I somewhere. This is called declaration. Okay, and one more thing is expressions. If you are writing on the fly expressions, you can do that like this. So if you don't want to write an entire scriptlet, but you are evaluating something in HTML itself, you can do that with the help of expressions. Like you are defining a p tag, today's date, and you are evaluating a statement. You are writing an expression for getting a date. So it can not getting that date, just getting a date. Okay, today's date. Okay, so new java.util.date and then to local string. You do to local string is not needed, so you can just print this. So let's take this example. You don't need scriptlet for this. So you have p tags in between, you're gonna write today's date. I'll make it open. Okay, and you are evaluating, you are writing an expression. This is expression, and you are just saying new date. You don't need local string anymore. You can just write this. This is today's date, and you wanna get it. Now, this is good. Okay, there is a good example. You don't have to specify enter class name. You can definitely do this and have an import, and it will get imported. So there is something called page import. Okay, and you can actually import java.util.date. We will see what is this page. You will see that this is called as directive, but that's not today's discussion. So now you can actually include this. So this is called expression. So there are three ways to use Java. One is a scriptlet. Scriptlet can have entire Java class, methods, declarations, expressions, everything. Still, you want to separate declarations, you can do that with the help of declaration tag. And expression is on the fly expressions. If I'm actually evaluating a very small stuff on the fly in HTML text, you can do that with the help of expression tag. Okay, that's it. So now run this example and see how it works. Just wait for server to synchronize. You don't have to restart it.